Hello everybody, today I would like to share with you a fun and easy way to decorate a simple notebook by using some stamping, embossing and coloring pencils. As you can see, I already did the front of the notebook, but I had some problems with my video, so I'll record only the backside process. I already stamped and embossed the images and colored the first flower here. So I'm planning to do these corners also. So before stamping, I am preparing my surface and applying this powder that helps to remove any static from my surface. This tool is from IKEA Success, and mine gets clogged all the time, and the powder just doesn't come out. And if I try to tap it onto my surface, the lid comes off and all my powder just spreads around. So I'm pouring a bit like this and apply it separately out of the container. So after applying it all over, I will go on and stamp my image. Now the stamp set that I used is from Altenew. It's called Persian Motifs. It has these great flowers that are perfect for coloring, and also has some great sentiments. So I'll just ink my stamp. I'm using the Versamark clear embossing ink, and I will stamp just a bit of the flower because I don't want my my surface to be too busy. So I will stamp it here. I initially wanted to leave it only with the two flowers, but I wanted also to record the video, so I decided to add two more. So as you can see, I stamp it here, and now I'll try to stamp another one here. Now this is my second video, so please excuse all my mumbling and all my I don't know any mistake that I make. So now I'm moving on to applying the powder. I use the embossing powder from Hero Arts. I keep it in a small container, and not all my embossing powders, but the ones that I use most. My container is small, and I cannot work directly on top of it with the piece that I'm working on. But if you have a bigger one, you can work directly on top of it. So I will just have all my powder here and then pour it back into the container. Okay, now if you have powder that got to places you don't want to, you just wipe it off with a brush. The problem with this container is also that it has this lid that doesn't come off, so when it gets lighter, it just does that, and the powder gets all over my craft surface. I'm planning to get to the containers that have the lid that comes out. So here is the embossed stamps, and I will turn on my embossing tool and see you in a bit. Okay, so I already embossed the images, and for embossing I use this heat tool from Ranger, and I don't like to use it for embossing because it has this big opening, and the heat sometimes just doesn't get to all the parts of the stamped image, and I have to move my paper around and try to direct the heat into the stamped image. For other things, like, I don't know, drawing or mixed media techniques, this is great. But for embossing, I would recommend the ones that have the longer tubes, and you can direct your heat to the places that you want. And with this one, it is a pain because the more you keep it on your image, it gets warmer and warmer, and you might even burn your hand. So for coloring my images, I use the Faber-Castell pencils. These are not watercolor pencils, and they work great with the Gamsol. And it is a great set. I got it for like 12 euros, I believe. There are 48 colors and great colors. I mean, I don't know, for red, you have like 3 or 4 shades, and for green also. Just look how many green colors you have with this set, and for $12 only. I mean, look, it's like 4 shades of green. 5, sorry. 5. It is great. And it also comes with 2 metallics. A gold one. No, this is a brown. Okay, the gold one. And the silver one. And even if you apply the Gamsol, they still shine, have the metallic shine if you tilt your paper into the light. I definitely recommend this if you are just starting with the coloring. And I also have the Prismacolors, but I got the set that has only 12 colors. And maybe because there are so few, I don't get such good results when I try to blend the colors. So I'm always starting with my darkest color. And apply it by flicking my pencil like this. And I always try to get the color not at the same level, but bring it more to the sides and less to the middle and more to the side again. Because if I do a straight line, when I go ahead and blend it, the effect is not that great. So I'm just flicking it and level it out. What do you call it? Okay, so this is the red. It's called Violet Leo. I don't know. It's a dark red. Okay. So if you get some color on the embossing, just don't worry. You can wipe it off with a baby wipe, and that's no problem at all. After applying the red, I will go ahead and apply some orange and try to obtain a peachy color. Now with the second color, I'm just filling in the spaces I didn't color with my darkest pencil. You just apply it as you feel it. You don't have to be perfect. I am not a coloring expert, or I don't even know to draw even a simple image. So the Gamsol helps a lot, and it does the most part of the job. Sorry, my camera. Okay, sorry for that. I will just dip my tip into the Gamsol and just apply it on top of my colors. Now the Gamsol helps smoothing out the color and blend the two colors, or three or four, how many apply. Initially I thought that the Gamsol works like I don't know, like when you're watercoloring and the color spreads around with the help of the water, even to places where you didn't apply it. But the Gamsol, even if it is liquid, it doesn't do that. It just smooths the color and removes the strokes that you might got from your pencil coloring. See all the shades? It is really, really pretty, and it seems that you just stay there and colored for, I don't know, minutes and minutes. It takes only a couple of seconds and you have that great effect. Now for my leaves, I use the gold as my darkest and an olive green for my lightest color. So I'm just flicking. When I flick, I have to come from the top to the bottom, and just applying it on the sides, and then apply the lighter one. And here is a leaf also. It's not too defined, but it is there. Okay. So the same process, just dip your paper stamp into the gamsol and apply it directly onto your colored image. It is beautiful. So I will go ahead and do the same for the second and the third flower. And I will see you in a bit. Okay, so here is the finished notebook. It came out really, really nice, I believe. I will make this a gift for a friend of mine, that's why I stamped the happy birthday here. I got this notebook from a local craft store. It has all these white pages on the inside. And the cover is made out of chipboard. And it has this great craft paper look. And even if I colored on a colored paper and not on a white paper, look how intense the colors are. I mean, these pencils are just great. I would like to change the color of this one too, if I find a white one or a golden one. Here it has a little pocket. It is really, really nice. And you can also decorate this side here with a washi tape or a strip of patterned paper, or use a, I don't know, stamp, an alphabet stamp, and write a person's name or a custom sentiment that you want. You can also add some sequins or, I don't know, buttons, ribbon, anything you like, just to make the perfect gift, or even for yourself. I believe this, you can make a great gift for yourself also. So this is it for today. I hope you enjoyed and gave you some inspiration, and I will catch you guys on my next video. Thank you. Bye bye.